Excuse me. Is that what's known as chili?
Don't eat it, just stir it.
That little talking dog on the commercial says that it's very good.
It's the wrong franchise. That's our mascot.
Rico the Taco Rat? Well, what do you recommend?
That you go someplace else.
Let's see. You know, I think I'll try the chimichanga.
It's your colon.
This normally quiet neighborhood is gripped with fear following the disappearance of 17-year-old Sarah Rickman, who, according to police, was taken from her home sometime during the early morning hours. The victim's parents have made an appeal to the abductor, begging for their daughter's safe return.
We just want whoever...
Anybody who can help us?
To return her
Anybody who can find us, please? Right
now, among bizarre details associated with the crime, the kidnapper apparently removed the eyes from several stuffed animals and left a message scrawled on a mirror.
Blue moon rising.
We'll have more as this story unfolds. Now, Paul, back to you in the studio.
We need your help. Something terrible has happened. A girl has been kidnapped. You need to find her.
Excuse me, Lieutenant Falk.
Who's he?
Special agent for your Justice Department.
I can't, Sydney. I'm scared.
You want to help Annie, don't you?
Sydney, no. I'm too scared.
Put your fear away.
But, Sydney, I can't.
You have to, Jared. You're the only one who can save her.
There are pretenders among us. I was taken from my family.
36,000. He's already demonstrating more talent than any of our others.
How many people died because of what I thought of?
Since I broke out, I've spent every moment searching for my past.
He's a pretender. A genius who can become anyone he wants to be.
Santa wants him alive.
Preferably. He defends the weak and abused.
Life's a gift.
You a doctor?
I am today.
That's funny. I don't remember calling in the Justice Department.
Jared Wrestling. I'm a criminal behaviorist. I'm here to help.
Go back to Washington. We have enough cops handling a kidnapping.
You won't be receiving a ransom note, Detective.
Lieutenant.
Look, the man that took Sarah is a killer. So every minute that we stand here arguing is a minute closer to her death. He's taunting you.
You think?
Cuts the eyes out. Makes him believe he's invisible. And these curtains, he left them open on purpose.
Look again, Kreskin. They're closed. They've been closed.
Actually, Lieutenant, they were open. I shut them to keep the news cameras out.
Talk.
I've seen this MO before. A series of crimes committed by a man named Douglas Willard.
Maxwell, APB this Willard.
Don't bother. He's been in prison for the last 20 years.
Okay.
lights are on when Noah's home.
Jared's life story.
Clearly, he was here. He was training for something aquatic.
Sid, Wonder Boy, ever say he wanted to be Mr. Olympic?
Not that I recall.
You know, when I was a kid, I always wanted to be Aquaman. You know? Human gills and the... Sorry. Hey, look. Looks like we might be going to Florida.
Looks like he did.
It's too easy. Look at all of these things he left behind.
Something unexpected must have come up, and Jared left before he planned.
Question is, where is he?
Doug Woolard, a.k.a. Blue Moon Killer.
Made a series of abductions along the Upper East Coast in the mid-70s. All young women snatched from their bedrooms. Eyeless dolls left behind, along with the words, Blue Moon Rising.
If Woolard's in maximum security...
We're dealing with a copycat.
Why Blue Moon?
It's the second full moon of a calendar month. Willard killed his victims at midnight of the Blue Moon.
Says here police got an anonymous tip out of Delaware that helped them catch Willard, but not before he murdered his last victim.
Her name was Annie. The body was never found.
There she is.
Everything you could. It's not your fault.
She died because of me, Sydney. I let her die.
If they never found her, how could they be sure?
Willard sent a photo of her body to her parents. It arrived the day after he was arrested.
Sick bastard.
Where do we start?
We find the copycat. Now he's meticulously recreating every detail of Willard's M.O. Details that weren't in the papers. Which means that he had some kind of contact with Willard.
No cellmate?
No, Willard's been in isolation since day one.
No family, no visiting privileges.
Do a rundown of all the prison personnel. Guards, doctors, public defenders, anyone.
I'm on it.
What would it take to get Willard transferred here?
Damn good reason, for starters.
How about someone is trying to become Willard? I need to pick the brain of the real thing.
So do your picking at McAllister.
I need him here where I can have access to him.
I can't do that for you.
The night after tomorrow is a blue moon. If we don't stop it, another girl is going to die.
Sydney, are those her parents?
Yes. And they're counting on you to find that order.
The more I learn about this guy, the sicker my gut feels.
Beth, the man that kidnapped Sarah is Douglas Willard.
I hope you're right. I just got off the phone with McAllister. Willard's in transit. He'll be here ASAP. You owe me.
Big time.
You know, Sid, sometimes I think you and I are the only people around here that are sane. Which isn't saying much for me. What's wrong? You got that just eaten in the cafeteria look.
I'm sorry. I'm fine.
Well, I'm not. Rains has convinced Daddy I should go down to Florida after Jared, even though I made it clear it's pointless.
Rains had nothing to do with it. I convinced your father.
Didn't we agree at the wharf Jared wasn't headed to Florida?
Maybe I was wrong. Maybe we overlooked something.
Cancel what I said earlier. I'm the only sane one around here.
Jared? How did you know?
Annie told me.
This time it's a girl named Sarah. I can't let it happen again.
You caught her killer. You saved countless others.
But I couldn't save Annie.
None of us can change the past, Jared. You did everything you could. You must get over it.
Willard gets transferred here in the morning. Sydney. Never seen him face to face.
But running away will offer no solace. You know what you have to do.
Jared. Jared.
I want to be alone with him.
Bad idea. The psychiatrist at McAllister calls Willard an earwig. You give him half a chance, he'll crawl into your head and chew in your brain. He's left two suicides and half a dozen psych discharges in his wake. I'm not afraid much, but I'm scared of him.
So am I.
Jared!
And who might you be, little boy?
Hope Jared knows what he's doing.
I owe you a thanks.
For what?
20 years in solitary, this is like a vacation.
I didn't do it for you.
Then why?
We'll get to that.
Nice accommodations. Of course, I'm used to a little bit more
privacy.
Smartass.
Who are you?
I'm Jared Ressler. I'm with the Justice Department.
Justice? I never realized that was so important.
You're not.
Just what is it you want?
I'm a criminal behaviorist. You're a case study. Interviewing you would broaden my knowledge.
Why do I get the feeling you're lying?
And why do I find it shocking that you have feelings?
Touché. The way I was a abruptly jerked from my peaceful abode and rushed here makes me think that my presence was urgently needed. It's almost as if it was a matter of life and death. Now, the feds are involved. That narrows down the list of possible crimes, doesn't it? I doubt if I was pulled in for terrorist bombing. It's not really my specialty. No, I'm going to take a wild guess and say abduction. Still, there must be a reason why you chose me, why I was selected. And that's the easiest one of all.
I'm on pins and needles.
Tomorrow night is a blue moon. And that leaves us with one conclusion. There's somebody else out there. Someone like me.
I'm impressed.
And you want my help?
Yes, I do.
Well, as I say, hell will freeze first.
Well, I am very sorry to have disturbed you. I'll make sure they take you back to your peaceful abode.
You down and you just walk away?
Patience.
I work like hell to get that guy here.
Wrestler! It's not as if I have somewhere else to be.
We burn half a day in the Sunshine State, sniffing trails, going nowhere. A standard cleanup crew could have checked that out. The question is, why were we sent? And what Sydney got to do with it?
Sydney wouldn't just send us to waste our time.
Unless he wanted us gone.
What?
I saw him staring at the photo in his office. That answers are there.
Yesterday, a young woman was taken. This young woman. Every detail of the crime was identical to yours.
Well, let me guess. You're looking for a white male, 22 to 35, unmarried, a loner. His neighbors are amazed and say he was a quiet man.
I know the standard profile. I need more, and there's little time.
If I give you what you need, will you give me what I need?
I already got you out of your hole, which means you owe me. Now, the copycat is recreating your last abduction, which means he's going to take his victim to the last place that you took yours.
Well, Lenny, I never found her, you know. It'll be the same with the new one if the copycat is as smart as I am.
And how does it feel to be the smartest man on the planet?
Lonely. Clearly, law enforcement has not raised its standards in the last 20 years. They're still the same stupid people that bungled their way through my capture.
But they did catch you.
Not in time. Besides, they didn't catch me. As I sat in my hole, I studied those who were supposedly responsible for bringing me to justice. I knew them better than they knew their wives.
And?
They couldn't catch a cold. They got a lucky break from the very gifted informant.
How do you know he was gifted? Maybe he was just lucky.
Because I'm smarter than that. He had to be really gifted, a genius. He was the worthiest adversary I've ever had. I was denied the opportunity to meet him. It was so disappointing. You see, I got inside my victims' heads. I knew where they lived, how they thought, how they act.
To know someone, you've got to get inside them. See, that's what I wanted to ask the anonymous informant for 20 years. I wondered, how did he get inside me? Do you know this man, Agent?
No.
Well, I only asked because I was wondering if he was as lonely on this planet as I am.
Well, like you said, being smart gets lonely sometimes. Now, where is this copycat going to take her?
You said it already. Same place I took Annie.
Where?
We've got till tomorrow midnight.
Tell me.
Oh, I can't do that. You'd send me back.
Answer me! Where is he going to take her? Where did you take Annie?
Relax, wrestler. Come on. If you don't control your emotions, you're never going to find him, are you?
No, Sidney, don't make me do it. I'm scared.
Time's running out, Jared. It's the only way we're going to find her.
No, please. Please, no.
I've got something I want you to look at.
Miss Parker, I don't like the idea of stealing from Sidney.
We're not stealing. We're just looking at it. Angelo, tell me about her. Who is she?
She's scared. Annie.
Tell me about Annie.
You want to go home.
Been there, done that. Waste of time.
A complete dry hole.
There were a few breadcrumbs.
And why are you here?
Because they were leading nowhere. Sidney, you want to clue him in? Florida's a boondoggle.
It's still our best chance at finding Jared. Get back down there.
We're not going anywhere, Burns.
But they just said we had to go back down.
And I said we're not. These two are up to something. You want to know everything that there is to know about her? This is the breadcrumb to follow.
Anything on prison personnel tied to Willard?
Working on it.
Hurry up, we're running out of time.
So are they.
I want to meet Annie's parents. If I talk to them, maybe I...
That's impossible. I don't want their emotions to cloud your objectivity.
But why are they so upset? Don't they have other children?
The emotions of parent and child share are strong and fragile. One child of ten, each relationship is unique. If threatened, they all feel immense pain.
I wonder if my parents cried for me.
If you imagine hard enough, it almost tastes like real coffee.
Thank you.
Before she went to bed that night, remember if I told her I loved her.
Mrs. Rickman, Sarah knows you love her.
I just can't help but wonder if everything is being done. If there isn't something more.
You have a lust for power. So be powerful. Save the girl.
Careful, Agent. Emotions cloud your eyes. They make you vulnerable. They make you
human?
You're a puzzle to me, Jared. Your passion makes me think there's more to you than meets the eye.
I want to find Sarah.
I want something, too. The truth.
About what?
I think you know. For 20 years, I've obsessed about my capture. I've read every piece of paper, every file, every document. And during those 20 years, I found nothing about an anonymous informant.
Well, that is the key word. Anonymous.
It must have been somebody who knew me, somebody who studied me as I study me. You seem to know me well.
I read your file.
Oh, you know more about me than is in my file. You know who I really am. And that makes me wonder who you really are.
What the hell is he doing?
Seems you and I have a secret. You were a child then. A prodigy.
I heard the word used, yes. How did you know?
I can see. I can feel your loneliness. A small child helps the police capture a genius. Now I am impressed.
I helped them capture a monster.
But it wasn't a time to save Annie, was it? Must be a terrible experience for someone as human as you. Makes me wonder how it's all going to work out for little Sarah. Like you said, time is running out.
Asleep when I enter. They all are. I know because I've been watching them.
Keep going, Jared.
I want to go to her, but I can't. Not while they're watching me. I have to stop them from watching me. Damn, it's invisible.
Why open the curtains, Jared? You don't want to be seen.
Moonlight. I need to feel it shining on me. I can't go any further, Sydney.
Yes. Yes, you can, Jared.
No. I don't want to be inside his head. I don't want him to have him inside of mine.
You have to.
No, I can't!
The only way we're gonna find Annie.
I can't, Sydney. I don't want to feel that. I don't want to feel that.
Detective Maxwell. Yeah, give me the info.
Why'd you pull the plug on Willard's surveillance cam?
Privacy.
His or yours?
I know what I'm doing.
You better. He's asking for you.
Talk to me.
You'll have to be more specific.
Rains wants me out of the way. You're singing back up. Why?
You're beginning to sound paranoid.
Then this must be one of my delusions. What's happening again, and why doesn't anybody want me to find out about it?
Parker. Leave the stone unturned.
You know, for years I've wondered who you really were. But inside, I always know. Is your name really Jared? Are you truly from the Justice Department?
My name is Jared. You wanted to see me.
He'll hold her till the moon is full.
Until midnight. I already knew that.
Actually, you already know everything. You have all the answers. You just won't do what you need to do.
Help me.
Why did I cut the eyes out of the dolls?
To make yourself invisible.
Why open the curtains?
To feel the moonlight on your body.
Why'd he do it?
The same reason.
Where is he?
I don't know.
Where is she?
I don't know!
Come on, Prodigy, do what you need to do. You had all the answers you needed to find Annie. I left them for you last time. He left them for you this time. Get inside his head. Get inside my head.
No.
Where is she?
I don't know.
You know, you've never asked me for what I wanted, what I need to help you.
Oh, really? Well, what do you need?
Take me to the crime scene. Take me to Sarah's bedroom.
And why would I want to do that?
Because I can feel it. Because I can do what you won't do. Become him.
I don't want to become him, Sydney.
They would never allow it.
You're a genius. You'll figure it out. Do it for Sarah. Do it for Annie.
Preston, we found the kidnapper.
Kidnapper's name is Paul Schumann. He was a guard at McAllister for 6 years. Worked nights, assigned a solitary confinement cell block, and...
Douglas Willard.
Oh, it gets better. Willard and Schumann developed a continuing conversation. 18 months ago, Schumann has a breakdown and vanishes. Well, the acorn's gone, but we found the right tree.
Got less than 8 hours until the moon is full. Look at this. Sarah, at home, waiting for the school bus. He's even got a class schedule.
Manta, New Bedford, Cape May.
Schumann visited all the places that Willard struck.
Historical tour?
Research trip. He's trying to get inside of Willard's skin.
By taking Sarah, he's picking up where Willard left off.
Over here. Letters from Willard. As recent as last week.
This is gibberish.
Mm-hmm. Code. To get past the prison censors.
Willard climbed into his head and earwigged him.
The question is Schumann a copycat? Or a puppet?
That's our next move.
We give Willard what he wants.
Did you think about taking me with you?
Tell me about Carl Schumann.
Answer me, I answer you.
He was your prison guard. Before you got inside of his head.
He was an impressionable fan, Jared. Frankly, it's irrelevant at this point.
Like these letters you wrote to him. You were behind Sarah's abduction from the very beginning. Schumann is just your eyes, your ears, and your legs out there, isn't he?
But now it's just you and me. Deja vu, Jared. It's like a snake eating its own tail. You're right back where you started, a scared little boy. You know who the killer is. But you can't save the girl.
least not alone.
Where did he take Sarah?
Same place I took Annie.
Tell me.
Do the right thing, Jared. Take me with you. We can still stop him.
He's not going anywhere. Agent Ressler, I want to talk to you. What the hell is this?
I know it sounds crazy, but if I could take Will to the crime...
Request denied.
A girl's life is at risk.
And risking more by letting that loose isn't the answer. Request denied.
Look, I know it's...
No! You know, at first I thought you knew what you were doing, but now I think he's here with you. You're out of here.
Once and for all.
I don't see any authorization.
Stay out of my way, Maxwell.
I can't let you do this.
No more time to waste. No more time.
Such a display of violence, Prodigy. She's sleeping as he cracks the door and slips inside. She has a summer cold. Her breathing is heavier than normal. He kind of likes that. And then he notices the eyes. He can't leave witnesses. He watches her. Oh, he can smell the soft scent of sweet powder. And what is that? Shampoo. Then what? No.
Tell me!
I don't want to become him, Sydney. I don't want him to be inside me.
What does he do next, Jared?
He wants to scream. Because it feels so... good. So right.
takes it down the hallway, doesn't it?
Past her parents' bedroom. He pauses. They're asleep. They look so innocent. So unaware.
Where does he take it next, Jared?
I don't know.
Feel it. The moon is full. It's almost midnight.
Look, I took you where you wanted to go. Now just tell me where she is.
It must be frustrating to be so close and yet so far away.
Tell me! Tell me where she is! Tell me!
Follow the clues to what you have to do.
I don't know! Now tell me where she is!
It's so obvious.
Why can't I figure it out? Why doesn't it make any sense?
Because it's all a lie. There is no rhyme or reason to any of this, Jared. There is no midnights, no blue moons rising. It's all meaningless. The truth is, I killed them because I wanted to. I like it. Now it's time for me to see Sarah. I expected a much more worthy adversary prodigy. Goodbye, Jared. It's time for the monster to leave now.
What'd you hear on the girl?
Wasn't a lot. Not even a last name. I mean, there's absolutely no reference to her last name. It's weird.
Bruce, don't waste my time telling me what you didn't find.
Okay. All I could find is that she was kidnapped and murdered 23 years ago. And there's not even a body been found.
Where did this happen?
About 40 miles from here, a place called Snow Hill, Maryland. Snow Hill.
Snow Hill.
You be, little boy.
Well, if it isn't the young prodigy.
How does it feel? To be the smartest man on the planet.
Lonely.
It's time to go back to your hole.
You found me, Jared. Once again, not in time to save the little girl.
Not this time. You see a request to visit the girl's bedroom. It was a ploy. So was my taking you there. I followed you here. Actually, I was one step ahead of you.
We all were.
Carl Schumann never got near this place.
Prodigy, you got inside my head.
No. You don't have to become a monster to face one.
Thank you.
She's over here.
It's okay. I'm here to help you. Nobody's gonna hurt you anymore.
It's okay, sir. Come on. You'll be okay.
Agent Wrestler?
Too, Annie.
This man?
Special Agent Wrestler?
Special Agent, right. Where is he?
He's right over there.
You saved her, Jaren.
I wish I could have done the same for Annie. For her parents.
I know you tried.
I hope that finally being able to bury her bring them some kind of peace.
I'm sure it will. I gave her father the locket. I know he'd like me to thank you. I'm sorry. I'm so very sorry.
Even the devil deserves a little privacy.